cowling. In the cowling there were holes drilled to allow the air to go through into the compartment below. So there's a plate been screwed into there to take the front, to take the plate, to give you an extra anchor to the plate. A hole has been put into the back, into the housing of the motor. That is where the air pressure from the motor is built up, and it normally comes down through a slot at the top. But to improve it, I put an extra hole there. It doesn't matter, you don't have to do that. But it's just an additional to increase the airflow. I have to remove the cowling now, so I'll turn the thing over, put the screws away. As I say, that's fascinating. Out of a short length of hose, which is very, very flexible and stretches for a long way. That's a piece of 1/4-inch plastic, which in this case has got a slight rebate around the edges to make it a better seal. There. Then a bridge is placed in there to help screw that back on, although there are additional fastenings down there, so you don't really need, you may not need that. That's relatively simple to construct, and that is the main part of returning the air to the cowling. Put that over there for a bit, no need to take it apart. Screw safely away if I want them again. It does. Oh, so I'll turn it over to take the base off. Yeah, that's the base. If I remember rightly, I've got to remove screws around there to get the hose. This is a conventional cover that can be removed first. Must be removed first to get to the roller brush. Incidentally, it needs a new belt. Which I'm going to take this opportunity to replace the belt. Yeah. In this case, I've drilled a row of holes along there to allow air to flow from either side of this. Those are not necessary, makes very little difference, but it was just an experiment. I'll sit there. Those holes there. There's a row of holes along there. So I'll put that over there. Right. As I say, the belts need replacing, but I'll do that a bit later. Now I want this out. Let's see. Again, if I can remember, I think they're just four screws to remove this. I've done all this without putting the bolt on. That's the cover for the belt. Comes off quite easily. As you see, 15 years, I don't think that's too bad. Currently now this is the interesting part. When the air is blown back through there from that hose, when the air is blown back through there from that hose, it doesn't want to go back to the back of the machine. It wants a cavity, a little chamber, in which to even out pressure. So a barrier is built up around there, like the foam. It's just built up out of foam, the sort of stuff you use to seal in doors and things. More than one layer, two or three layers, till it presses tight onto the roof, onto the top. Till it presses tight onto the top of the housing or cowling. Down there, go cloth there down there, two or three layers to make a little chamber for the air to build up, even out the pressure. Remember, it's blowing in through the top. Now, there's a row of holes built along just above the brush there, and they're built, not very small ones down this end, you hardly see them. Down the bottom there, as near as the bottom as I can get, some small ones along there, and then some rather large ones nearer the top. So when the air builds up in there, it's easier to travel to that end, which is away from the vacuum end. It's easier for the air to travel to that end than there, so it's an even flow onto the brush. The air flows onto the brush. Picked up by the brush and goes into the inlet there, which is then drawn back up into the housing of the dust separating device, whether it be a bag or a cyclone, to separate the dust from the air. So the air's come through there, round there, into there. On the way, that's spinning around, so the air's travelling around there, picking up the dust and dirt and blowing it in, blowing and sucking at the same time into that aperture there. Now, let me see if I can show you this. Oh, that's a good idea. So, there isn't any. I've already taken the bag out. So, back again, as you see, pretty clean. Now, and there, see if I can get a better picture. Well, now the air blown back into there, picked up through those holes, picked up by the roller, pushed in to that aperture there, which goes along and into the base, into the bottom of the dust bag housing. It is then blown down, blown out there, or blown and sucked, because now you've got a blowing pressure and a suction power from the base. So the two assisting together to blow it into the bag. The bag separates the dust and the air goes back down through there, into the housing of the motor, through there, back through the air coupling, into the top of the housing. Down there, back round again. Yeah, it's blowing through there, into the hose, through the hose, to the top of the cowling, through those holes, and into the cowling, there, down through those holes there onto the brush. The brush is rotating, takes it and blows it through the vacuum input there, through the input port there, along through there, up through the cleaner, at the back through this pipe in the cleaner there. See that one there? That's the pipe that takes it up. to the top, where it goes round and back down through there into the bag. Now, a lot of cleaners don't have the pipe inside there, they have a hose on the outside. They use an extra hose on the outside going into the top. This is neat because it's got the pipe on the inside. Restricts the amount of space, but it works okay. I don't know whether I can say much more. I think I'd better start reassembling it for the next part of the video. I'm not sure whether I'll have to do this again. This is a plate fastened out of a piece of 1/4 inch plastic. It's a 1 inch hole there, 1 inch hole there, fashioned into a single turn thread with a half round file. I just fashioned it so this is just a single turn thread in order to take the hose, to screw the hose in. Like that. The other end of the hose goes into this attachment made from a brush, one of the tools of the machine. It's a brush which has had the ends cut off. Both the ends are being cut off on the base and the bottom to make just a little cap to cover the lid, the top of the cleaner, an attachment to put the hose back into. Back on there.